Almost 60,000 fans have poured into Outzen Stadium, and as usual, they're revved up for this one. It's time for the coin toss now, presented by Coke Zero. Real Coke taste, zero calories. Enjoy everything. Colorado will be kicking off, and you can just feel the energy in the air for this opening kickoff. Fielded at the four. He's tackled at the 31-yard line. Kickoff returns 27 yards. Now the offense gets ready to take their first crack at it. And he's tackled right around the 40. They'll bring him down for a loss on the play.
That is just a great play getting into the backfield. This guy is so quick that the ball carrier never had a chance.
So it's third down, and they've got about 2 yards to go. On the run. They'll bring him down at the 41-yard line.
Well, that's a big-time stop by the defense. You know, Brad, one of the things that all defensive coordinators always try to emphasize is their ability to stop offenses on third down. That is a big stop, and I think it could have a lot to do with the outcome of this football game.
He just took a licking. The Buffaloes and their coaching staff, Kirk, just happy to have a guy like this in the program. Their offense really clicks when he's playing well.
Well, I think it gives them the diversity that they're looking for. I mean, at times they're going to run the football. Other times they're going to try to air it out. When you have one guy that gets so much attention on the outside, it just seems to open up other aspects of their offensive attack. And they've done a good job as an offensive staff of putting together a good plan. And I'm sure we're going to see it again today.
From their own 37-yard line. Second down, empty backfield, quarterback in the gun, five wide receivers. Quick throw out to the receiver, and he shoved out of bounds right around the 44-yard line.
That makes it third and three.
Reset, tight right. Mike 35. Come on out here, come get some.
He's out.
Quick strike to the receiver. Tackle made at the 35.
This isn't even the best example, but I'm going to tell you something. This young man is really getting better at running his routes, which is a truly underrated quality these days.
First and 10. Ball on the 35-yard line. Strike to his receiver, no good.
Stanley was the intended receiver on the play. That makes it second.
Man left, man left. Down. Mike 35.
Up the middle for a nice gain.
Gain of 5 on the play. That'll bring up 3rd and 4.
Third down again. Lost the ball, fumble. The defense scoops it up. So it's the cornerback that comes up with a fumble, and this ball will change hands.
Fumbles will absolutely drown an offense. It's hard to get into a rhythm when you make mistakes like that.
They're going to review this fumble, and I've got to tell you, I think he was down before the ball popped loose.
I don't know about this one, Brad. They called it a fumble on the field, and they need indisputable video evidence to overturn this call.
After review of the play, the ruling on the field is reversed.
Well, after seeing the replay, it was apparent that his knee was down before he lost the ball.
Yep. Those guys in the booth aren't perfect, but they got it right this time.
Mike 35, Mike 35.
from the 15-yard line. First down. Quick throw out to the receiver. Incomplete.
Down the intended receiver on the play. That makes it second and 10.
The throw, incomplete pass.
Man, this is tough going for this quarterback. Next time out, he needs to just relax, think back to all those practices, and not worry about what's happened in this game up to now.
Colorado is looking to go up by three. Kicks up, and it sails through the uprights. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. Excellent kick. He's to the 20. And he's tackled at the 28-yard line. Colorado's got people flying all over the field on defense right now.
Boy, they sure do. Right now, we're just seeing great defensive effort. They have a plan. They understand it. They're playing with great speed, and they're not giving up big plays. That's why they're playing well up to this point.
You never like to have to play from behind, but a deficit this manageable shouldn't be in the front of their minds. They just need to go out there and play. Tackle right around the 36-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 8 yards. That'll bring up second and 3.
Gives it off. Good outside run there. So he picked up a few on that run.
Yeah, he did a nice job of using his blockers on that run. Really nice read.
He's at midfield. Inside the 30 to the 20. That's a great tackle at the 9.
Again, 59 yards.
This defense is looking to make it 3 straight trips to the red zone without a single point. Again with the run. He's taken down at the 6. To the tailback, incomplete.
I mean, he has his wide receiver wide open. You spend all those hours during the week to be able to get prepped and ready to go. You got an open man like this, just step and deliver and make the throw.
Would have been a big play by the defense. He can't hold it.
Number 3, the intended receiver on the play.
They're going to go for the easy 3 here.
Fourth and goal.
Oregon is looking to tie things up. He gets it up, and it's good.
And you got to think they're pretty happy with holding him to a field goal right there.
Lewis has his kick team lined up, and he is set to kick this one off. He'll return it from the 3. He's to the 20. They bring him down, and they bring him down hard on that one. Got to give some applause to the defense. They really came out playing strong today.
Well, you know better than me, Brad. This college football game is about emotion. And to be able to play great defense in the college game, you've got to come out and play with your hair on fire. We've seen that from both of these defenses so far.
I don't think either team has a clear advantage so far. Let's see if they can make some plays and get a little separation. Tackle after a decent run up the gut.
That's a gain of 7 on the play.
They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down. He's tackled at the 27. Quarterback all by himself in the backfield with 5 wideouts. Looks to him again, complete. And they make the stop at the 43-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 16 yards. First down.
from their own 43-yard line. First down.
Mike 41. You got a wedge there.
He makes it to the 45-yard line.
That's a gain of two. That makes it second and eight.
The Buffaloes had one of their key players go down earlier, but it looks like he might be able to get back in the lineup. Gets to about the 47-yard line. And they'll look to convert here on another third down. We played one, 3-3 tie. Welcome back to the action. Just about set to start quarter number two, and we're all tied up. Flushed out, and he's going to get sacked. They've got 10 guys up. It looks like they're going to try to block this one. Knocked out of bounds. Right around the 38-yard line. This is the point in the game where you don't want to make any mistakes that give the other guys a reason to feel more confident going into halftime. And he's taken down. Right around the 48-yard line.
Second and inches.
Three down.
Let's check, go. Check.
Runs outside for a nice game.
The quarterback held on to it and turned it into a first down. That's very frustrating for this defense.
Brought down around the 40-yard line.
Called a gain of 8 yards. That brings up second and one.
Three down.
Let's go. Here we got Mike, number three.
Check.
980.
Hammerhead.
Nice run there.
I love this wide receiver. I know what he can do catching the football, but man, oh man, he's trying to get in line to say, hey, I want to carry the football. He's trying to push that starting running back out of a job.
And he makes it out to about the 34-yard line.
Gain of two on the play. That makes it second and eight.
Get to the ball.
Here we go. Check 99.
Quick throw. A junior makes the catch. Touchdown, Ducks.
Excellent play here by the quarterback, making the proper reads and finding his playmaker for the score.
Boy, that was an easy throw for the quarterback. Had to be a mistake of some kind or miscommunication by the defense in that secondary, but the quarterback finds his receiver wide open for the touchdown.
And he converts the extra point. A six-play, 63-yard drive, and it's good for 7 points.
And, Brad, right now the offensive line just winning the battle in the trenches, opening up some big running room.
The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. He'll return it from the 4-yard line. Across the 30. They'll bring him down at the 32. There hasn't been too much daylight between these two teams. In games like this, some players try to press too much, and that can cause mistakes. He's to the 40. He makes his way to about the 42.
That's a gain of 10 on the play.
It's first and 10. Ball on their own 42. He's at midfield. And down he goes at about the 41.
Call it a gain of 17 yards. That makes it first and 10.
Gets to about the 41-yard line.
No gain. That makes it second and 10.
Second down, 10 to go.
Ball on the 41-yard line.
In the shotgun and five wideouts. First down, Graham. Good tackle there in space.
Number 6 brings him down at the 25-yard line. First down.
From the 25-yard line, it's first down.
Three down.
35's the mic. Here you
go. Go. They'll knock him down for a loss.
This defensive end just showed us why he's much more than just a pass rusher.
That brings up second and 13.
Here comes the pressure. And he's tackled at the 21-yard line.
Gain of 7 yards. Third down.
Third down, and they need to get it to the 15.
Roger. Mike 35. I got one.
Fires quick to an open man. He dropped it. To that quickly. They'll bring him down at the 15-yard line. Pretty good gain. More importantly, though, it's good for the first down.
That's heartbreaking for a defense. They stopped him on the first three plays, but they just couldn't contain the pass on fourth down.
He makes his way out to about the 6. Colorado will take their second time out of the half, and this is the 10th play of the drive. Short yardage situation here. It's third and 1. Fires quickly, and they got it. Touchdown. That was a well-drawn-up play for the wideout.
Yeah, they saw something upstairs. It led to a touchdown. You can thank the play calling there. Very impressive.
And it takes some real accuracy on those deep corner routes, so kudos to the quarterback. Here comes the kicker to try to tie this game up. And he adds the extra point. An 11-play, 68-yard drive, and a touchdown as a result.
Brad, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
This one's all even at 10. Oh, man, he took him down hard. The offense really came up with a nice drive there last time out, and most of those yards came through the air.
This defense needs to improve from front to back. The line needs to put more pressure on the quarterback, and the defensive backs need to stick it to these receivers with tighter coverage.
And he is drilled at the 32-yard line. The Ducks will use their first time out of the half. So it's second down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first. There's a strike complete. There's another pass to the tight end, and he's got it. Tackle made around the 48-yard line. Scrambling. Tackle at the 49.
Gain of 1 on the play. That brings up second and 9.
31's the mic.
Throws complete and he stopped immediately. Oregon's going to have to use their second time out of the half. They're about 4 yards away here on third down. Has some daylight. He gets hit out of bounds at the 36. Quick throw. He's taken down right around the 22-yard line.
Check, check. Spider! Spider!
Go, go.
Ready! Red 18!
Throw's complete. He's got space to work. Now it's first and goal as he's knocked down after a nice game.
That's pretty impressive. Accuracy is important, but just as important is having receivers that can make plays.
It's first down, and they'll be looking for 6 points here. They line up in the jumbo set.
Here we go!
Heading for the corner. Touchdown, Oregon!
That was a very good all-around effort. The running, the blocking, the entire package. A well-deserved score.
You knew that that touchdown was going to be won or lost in the trenches. He makes the PAT. Oregon ready to kick this one off. It's fielded at the 2. He's to the 20. Looking for the corner. He's pushed out of bounds at the 29-yard line.
This is my kind of game. We're getting a chance to see so many touchdowns. I just wonder if this offense can continue the flow that we've seen from the previous three series.
They ran the ball very well on their last drive, and it resulted in 6. Stays in bounds to make a nice catch.
That's the kind of play calling and execution I like to see. Being one-dimensional on first down can really stack the odds against you. It's better to mix it up.
From their own 43-yard line, first down. And he's hit before he can go anywhere.
That'll make it second and inches.
He's going to air it long. Finds the junior. He'll take it all away for the touchdown.
This offense just has so many weapons to defend. They've got some genuine playmakers.
Here's the PAT to tie this thing up. And he hits the PAT. It was a quick 3-play, 72-yard drive, and they come away with 7 points. This game is all tied up at 17. We played a half of football. Good game here, 17-17.
Hi, everybody. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Davis, David Pollack here in the studio as always, to lend a little perspective to what just went down in the first 30 minutes. Neither offense ran into anything that suggested any type of trouble for them in the first half, both running up and down the field pretty much at will. Did you get the sense, David, that the defenses were a little tentative, that they were a little shell-shocked by what had happened? And if so, what do they need to do to change that in the second half?
It's hard not to get that sense when the offense just goes shoot, 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 up and down the field and has success. But, you know, it's interesting. If you're going to continue to give up points and you know your offense is continuing to score, why not get aggressive on defense? I mean, don't sit back. Don't let them dink and dunk. Don't let them run the football. Bring some guys up in the box. Play some man coverage. If you're going to give up points and you know you're scoring at a high clip, go for the gusto, baby. Try to make some big plays.
Just about set to start the second half. What are you looking for?
I'm looking to see which team has that decided schematical advantage.
And if they can find it, they'll blow holes 3 or 4 axe handles wide. Brad and Kirk will be there to call the second half.
great first half and a tight ball game. And we're set to start quarter number three. Taken from the 3-yard line. He's tackled at the 22. Wow, close game here. Up and down the field with both these offenses matching what the others done.
Well, it's fun to watch each offense get an opportunity to go out and make plays. And you're right, you almost feel as if one offense feels challenged and has to be able to bounce back, and they've done that.
Time's getting a little bit tighter now. You got to make every possession count. And now he's got room to run. Nice run, and he's brought down.
That's good for a gain of 5 yards. That brings up second and five.
We've got a second and five. Ball on the 27-yard line.
Man left, man left. Watch 38. Watch 38.
He's knocked out of bounds at the 42-yard line.
Call it a gain of 15 yards. That makes it first and 10.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 42-yard line.
Mike 41. You've got a wedge man.
And he makes it out to about the 44-yard line. Quickly, and that was almost picked.
This just shows you that you don't need to be sacking the quarterback to disrupt the passing game.
Third down, and they need to get it inside the 48. Pulls it in, and he's in the open field. He's at the 40. And they finally knock him out at the 27.
First down.
From the 27-yard line. First down.
Mike 35. Man, that's trash. That's trash.
And he carries the ball for a nice game.
A gain of 4 yards.
Let's go.
That brings up second and five.
Not today, you are. Not today. 41's coming. 41's a Mike.
Inside the 10, a huge play, and now they're in a great position to score.
15 yards.
First down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line.
Mike 41, Mike 41. Here we go, deep, all day, defense, all day.
Fires quickly, and he's got his man. He's tackled around the 1 yard line.
Number 23 makes the tackle at the 1 yard line.
It's the ninth play of the drive.
Second and goal.
Watch out for a pass play when you're in a goal line D. Diving for extra yardage.
No gain on the play. That makes it third and goal.
From the 1 yard line, it's third down. Touchdown, Buffaloes.
Great job of finding the space to run and just bursting in for six. That is a clutch touchdown. Tie game, and they find a way to put it in for six. I know there's a lot of time left, but that was a big one.
He splits the uprights with the extra point. A 10-play, 78-yard drive, and they get it in for seven.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass. Just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
So the score now, 24-17. He's taken down at the 27-yard line.
I love the competitive spirit that we're seeing out on this field today. It looks like one team has the upper hand, and then the other comes right back in to be able to regain the lead. It's going to be an exciting finish.
There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing. They go with a run, and he brought down in the backfield.
Call it a loss of 4 yards on the play. That makes it second and 14.
From their own 23-yard line, second down.
Three down. 31's the mic. Set. Run.
He'll get the call again. He steps out at the 29.
Gain of 6 on the play.
Roger, Roger. 31's the mic. Let's go, D. It's going to be a long day, offense. It's going to be a long day. Here we go. 99.
He airs it out. The senior makes the catch. Touchdown!
They pretty much had their way with the defense there. Terrific play.
They'll line up for the extra point in an attempt to tie the game. And he converts the extra point. So a short three-play, 73-yard drive, and it results in a touchdown.
Boy, that is scoring in a hurry. This offense is looking more and more explosive.
Looks like they're ready for the kick. Fielded at the 4. He's to the 20. Across the 30. Brought down by the kicker. Colorado's dreams are a reality in this football game. They've scored 21 points in a row. These guys came up with a touchdown on their last drive, and they'll be hoping for another 6 on the board here.
I think the defense right now is just sitting back on their heels. They're allowing the offense to kind of dictate things to them. And one thing is that any defensive coordinator will tell you in the country, you have to be the one trying to dictate things to the offense. So change it up. Try something different. If it's not working, you can't continue to sit back on your heels.
From their own 40-yard line, it's second down. Gains his way to the 49-yard line.
Gain of 9 yards. First down.
Here we go. I got eight. Pick it up, guys. Pick it up.
Go.
Going deep. Incomplete. Almost picked off. That could have been a big play for the defense.
Yeah, even though he had a good shot at picking it off, it's still a heck of a play to force the incomplete pass.
Second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on their own 49. He's got an opening. He's at the 40. Makes it out to about the 29.
Gain of 22 yards. That makes it first and 10.
And he's tackled at the 16-yard line.
Makes the tackle at the 16-yard line.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 16.
Four down. Watch number 12.
Slings it. And he's taken down at about the 3-yard line.
That's a gain of 13 on the play. That makes it first and goal.
Check. 35's
the mic. Touchdown, Colorado!
Man, the big fella's a battering ram, isn't he? He's almost impossible to slow down in short yardage situations.
And he tacks on the extra point. A 7-play, 65-yard drive, and they come away with a touchdown.
Brad, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
At the 30, tackle made at the 32. They did a great job on their last drive, moving the ball down the field for a touchdown. Let's see if they can duplicate that on this drive.
As long as this quarterback has time to throw, then you can guarantee that he'll find the open man.
Brought down around the 29-yard line.
That's a loss of 3 yards on the play. That brings up second and 13.
Second and 13. Ball on the 29. Points galore through three. An action-packed fourth quarter is on deck. 31-24, Buffaloes. Into the fourth quarter now, and we're back to the action.
31's the mic. I'm coming after you.
And they make the stop at the 28-yard line.
That's how we do, D. That's how we do.
That was a loss of 1 yard.
They don't want none of this.
That brings up third and 14.
When you're in a position like this where it's late in the game, you just cannot afford to have such an unproductive possession.
Fourth down.
He gets out to about the 48-yard line.
Return for a gain of 14 yards.
This is a pretty crucial series right here. With things being so tight, your best players have to step it up on both sides of the ball. Colorado is up a score. Brought down after a nice run up the middle.
That's good for a gain of 3 yards. That makes it second and 6.
From the 48-yard line, second down. He's got to throw it in a hurry. And he's going to be sacked.
The protection broke down. The defense was in the backfield in a hurry, and they brought the quarterback down. Nice play.
Third down now, and they need to get it inside the 42.
35's the mic.
He steps up. Pulls it in. First down, and he's knocked out of bounds.
Good job by the offensive line to pick up the linebacker on the blitz. That gave the quarterback enough time to find his man for a nice game.
No, gets the call. Runs outside for a nice game.
That's a gain of 4 on the play. That brings up 2nd and 5.
It's 2nd and 5 here. Ball on the 33-yard line.
Check it out, check it out, check it out. 6:48. Yes, yeah, it. Check, check, check.
After positive yardage.
That's a gain of 5 on the play. That'll make it 3rd and 1.
Short yardage situation here. It's 3rd and 1. Just under 3 to go in regulation.
Ah!
Now he's flushed and they got him. The Ducks taking their first time out of the half. It's fourth down and they're going to try to go for it. Quick throw. He gets hit out of bounds at about the 23-yard line. Here's the eighth play of the series. Again, he'll get the call. Tackle made at the 20. Oregon will take their second time out of the half. Second down and 7 coming up here. Ball on the 20. Tackle at the 19-yard line. Oregon's out of timeouts. Here's a running play. They'll bring him down for a loss on the play. Fourth down. They'll line it up for the field goal. Is up and it is good. Now that really puts the pressure on.
Yeah, that was definitely a big field goal because now that puts them up by 2 scores and there's not much time left on the clock.
Colorado lines up for the kickoff. He'll return it from the 4-yard line. And down he goes at the 29-yard line. So now both teams come trotting back out onto the field. A little over a minute in the game. He's taken down around the 46-yard line. A heck of a play by the receiver.
We talk all the time about the emotions of college football. This play was definitely an emotionally charged play. What a way for the wideout to make a statement in this game.
Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 46. Strike to his receiver, no good. He wants it all, going long. And it's caught. Touchdown, Oregon! Late in the fourth quarter, and the big question is, in a game this close, who's going to crack first? Here's the extra point to draw within 3 points. And he adds the extra point. A 4-play, 71-yard drive, and they add 7 points to the scoreboard.
I think the big thing there, Brad, is that they were able to execute the passing game. When you can get big plays and great execution, obviously you're going to move the ball down the field.
They don't recover the onside, so they'll really be counting on their defense to come up with a turnover in order to win this thing.
Well, this is the biggest series of the game. A stop here, and they're back in business. But if they give up a touchdown, it's all over.
We should just see the quarterback take a knee right here, winding down the rest of this clock. Second and 12 coming up here. Ball on the 47. Colorado has a 3-point lead. He takes a knee, looking to take some time off that clock. And so that's going to do it. Our final score in this one, 34-31, Buffaloes. 31.
That's going to do it for this presentation of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, this is Brad Nessler saying goodbye.